sing to the Lord and rejoice. For He is risen. Sing to the Lord, O the earth. Sing to the Lord, O the earth.
Good afternoon, brothers and sisters.
Good afternoon, to Father.
This afternoon, as we celebrate the feast of Saint Athanasius, Bishop and Doctor of the Church, we ask for his intercession, as well as the intercession of Saint Padre Pio and the Blessed Virgin Mary, not only to pray for our own personal intentions and intentions of those who sponsored this afternoon's Mass, but the intention of the Church, the intention of the National Shrine of St. Padre Pio, specifically for healing of those who are sick, of those who are in need of inspiration, divine inspiration, for those who are hopeless, for those who are faithless, we'll continue to pray for them, and we'll continue to ask the intercession of all saints in order to bring them or give them hope and inspiration and go back to the fold of the Church. We begin the celebration in the name of the Father and of the Son and of the Holy Spirit.
Amen.
The Lord be with you.
And with your spirit.
Coming together as God's family, dear brothers and sisters, we recall to mind all our sins and ask the Lord for pardon and strength. All together we pray, I confess
to Almighty God and to you, my brothers and sisters, that I have greatly sinned in my thoughts and in my words, in what I have done and in what I have failed to do, through my most grievous fault. Therefore, I ask Blessed Mary, ever Virgin, all the angels and saints, and you, my brothers and sisters, to pray for me to the Lord our God.
May the Almighty God have mercy on us, forgive us our sins, and bring us to everlasting life.
Amen.
Let us pray. Almighty ever-living God, who raised up the Bishop Saint Athanasius as an outstanding champion of your Son's divinity, mercifully grant that, rejoicing in his teaching and in his protection, we may never cease to grow in knowledge and love of you, through our Lord Jesus Christ, your Son, who lives and reigns with you in the unity of the Holy Spirit, one God forever and ever.
Amen.
A reading from the Acts of the Apostles. After much debate had taken place, Peter got up and said to the apostles and the presbyters, "My brothers, you are well aware that from early days God made his choice among you, that through my mouth the Gentiles would hear the word of the gospel and believed. And God, who knows the heart, bore witness by granting them the Holy Spirit, just as he did us. He made no distinction between us and them, for by faith He purified their hearts. Why are you now putting God to the test by placing on the shoulders of the disciples a yoke that neither our ancestors nor we have been able to bear? On the contrary, we believe that we are saved through the grace of the Lord Jesus in the same way as they. The whole assembly fell silent and they listened while Paul and Barnabas described the signs and wonders God had worked among the Gentiles through them. After they had fallen silent, James responded, "My brothers, listen to me. Simeon has described how God first concerned himself with acquiring from among the Gentiles a people for his name. The words of the prophet agree with this, as it written, 'After this I shall return and rebuild the fallen hut of David. From its ruins I shall rebuild it and raise it up again, so that the rest of humanity may seek out the Lord, even all the Gentiles on whom my name is invoked.' Thus says the Lord, who accomplished these things known from old. It is my judgment, therefore, that we ought to stop troubling the Gentiles who turn to God, but tell them by letter to avoid pollution from idols, unlawful marriage, the meat of strangled animals, and blood. For Moses, for a generation now, has had those who proclaim him in every town, as he has been read in the synagogues every Sabbath." The word of the Lord.
Thanks be to God. Responsorial Psalm. Let the response be, proclaim God's marvelous deeds to all the nations.
Proclaim God's marvelous deeds to all the nations. Sing to the Lord a new song. Sing to the Lord, all you lands. Sing to the Lord, bless his name.
Proclaim God's marvelous deeds to all the nations.
Announce his salvation day after day. Tell his glory among the nations, among all peoples, his wondrous deeds.
Proclaim God's marvelous deeds to all the nations.
Say among the nations, the Lord is King. He has made the world firm, not to be moved. He governs the people with equity.
Proclaim God's marvelous deeds to all the nations. Please all stand.
Alleluia, 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 alleluia.
My ship knows my voice, says the
your spirit.
A reading from the Holy Gospel according to John.
Glory to you, O Lord.
Jesus said to his disciples, "As the Father loves me, so I also love you. Remain in my love. If you keep my commandments, you will remain in my love, just as I have kept my Father's commandments and remain in his love. I have told you this so that my joy might be in you and your joy might be complete. Brothers and sisters, the Gospel of the Lord.
Praise to you, Lord Jesus Christ.
If you would recall last Sunday's Gospel, it talks about Jesus as the vine and we are the branches. And our Gospel this afternoon is a continuation of that theme, that we remain to be branches, different branches of the vine who is Jesus. And very specific and very clear, or Jesus' mandate in this afternoon's Gospel is very clear and very specific: to remain in His love. Why is it important to remain in His love as a disciple or as disciples? Let me put it this way. Yung kultura natin na alagaan ang mga may sakit nating matatanda at isakripisyo natin yung ating opportunities because of our aged parents, our aged grandparents, ay hindi maintindihan ng ibang kultura. No? Sa kanila, pag maedad ka na, dadalhin ka na sa home for the aged. At hindi sila magsasakripisyo ng kanilang sarili at gagamitin nila ang pera para maalagaan yung kanilang mga matatanda. At okay din naman, sapagkat mas maganda nga naman doon dahil sila ay maalagaan ng husay, may nurse, may caregiver, ang mga gamot, siguradong mapapainom. Kaya lang, sa kultura natin, hindi yun, well, may mga iba na nagsisimula ng ganito. Sa kultura natin, generally, hindi pa ito tanggap. Bakit? Sapagkat para sa atin, yung pagsasakripisyo para sa kanila, lalo ng pag-aalaga sa kanila, is a kind or is a form of love. Hindi madaling mag-alaga. Hindi madaling magtiyaga sa may sakit na mahal sa buhay na mainitin ang ulo. Pero bakit natin ginagawa? It's not only an act of gratitude, but it is an act of love. At ganun tayo, ganun natin naintindihan ano ang ibig sabihin ng pagmamahal. Bakit kayo nagtsatsaga na igabay ang inyong matigas na ulo na anak na pagkatapos ninyong isakripisyo ang inyong kinabukasan, ang inyong sana ay magandang kinabukasan, patuloy pa rin sumusuway sa inyo pero hindi kayo nagsasawa na bumitaw sa Kanya? The reason is love. Wala nang iba. At ang pagmamahal na yan is not an emotional kind of love, but it is a love or a love that is a decision. Mabuti ang ginagawa o hindi. Patuloy na magmamahal sa magulang na may sakit. Patuloy na aalagaan kahit nahihirapan financially, pagkakasyahin, titipirin. Ganun din sa anak. O ganun din sa asawang taksil. Because of love. A love that does not depend on situations, but an act of the will, deciding in favor of the good. At yung ganyang klase ng pagmamahal ang sinasabi ng ating Panginoong Jesus ngayong hapong ito. Why is it very important for us disciples. Because alam ng ating Panginoong Jesus na marami tayong pagdadaan ng struggle. Na papasok tayo sa butas ng karayom bago natin marating yung perfection na hinihingi sa atin bilang Kristiyano. And it takes so much love. A love that is unconditional and a love that is a decision in order to win the battle against imperfection. At ang pagmamahal na yan, at ang pananatili sa pagmamahal na yan mula sa ating Panginoong Jesus, ang mahalaga at kailangan natin para hindi tayo mawala ng pag-asa, para manatili tayong nananampalataya at hindi tayo mawala kay Jesus habang tayo ay pinupurify at naglalakbay patungo sa Kanya galing sa mundo o sa mundong ibabaw. That's why it's very important. His mandate to remain in His love this afternoon is very important for all of us, because without that love and by not remaining on that love, madali tayong mawawala. Madali tayong mawawala ng pag-asa. Madaling masisiraan ng loob. Lalo na sa mga panahon na hindi ayon sa atin at sa ating pananaw at panglasa ang kalooban ng Diyos. That's why it makes sense to remain in His love, to continue our belief, to continue hoping sa Panginoong Jesus na muling nabuhay. Our dear brothers and sisters, this afternoon, we are invited as branches of the vine Jesus to remain with Him. Remaining in Him, remaining in love with Jesus will help us continue our journey as we fight against different kinds of pressures, different kinds of temptations, different kinds of options that are not actually godly. At ngayong hapon, tayo po ay inaanyayahan na piliin ang pananatili sa ating Panginoong Jesus upang marating natin ang kabanalan o perfection na inaasahan sa atin bilang mga binyagan at bunga ng Kanyang muling pagkabuhay.
For your offerings in the envelope, you may drop them at the collection baskets.
Lord, we gather today in your house, we kneel down and pray. We ask for your mercy as we open our hearts to receive your forgiveness, O Lord.
Stand.
Pray, brethren, that my sacrifice and yours may be acceptable to God, the Almighty Father.
May the Lord accept this sacrifice at your hands for the praise and glory of His name, for our good and the good of all His holy Church.
Look, O Lord, upon the offerings we present to You in commemoration of Saint Athanasius, and may witnessing to Your truth bring salvation to those who profess, as He did an unblemished faith, through Christ our Lord.
Amen.
The Lord be with you.
And with your spirit.
Lift up your hearts.
We lift them up to the Lord.
Let us give thanks to the Lord our God.
It is right and just.
It is truly right and just, our duty and our salvation at all times, to acclaim you, O Lord, but in this time above all to laud you yet more gloriously, when Christ our Passover has been sacrificed. Through him the children of light rise to eternal life, and the halls of the heavenly kingdom are thrown open to the faithful. For his death is our ransom from death, and his rising the life of all has risen. Therefore, overcome with paschal joy, every land, every people exalts in your praise, and even the heavenly powers with the angelic hosts sing together the unending hymn of your glory as they acclaim.
Holy, 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 Lord God of hosts, heaven and earth are full of your glory, the sun high the highest. Blessed is he who comes in the name of the Lord, the sun high the highest.
Those who are unable to kneel, please remain standing with reverence.
You are indeed holy, O Lord, the fount of all holiness. Make holy, therefore, these gifts, we pray, by sending down your Spirit upon them like the dewfall, so that they may become for us the body and blood of our Lord Jesus Christ. At the time he was betrayed and entered willingly into his passion, he took bread and, giving thanks, broke it and gave it to his disciples, saying, "Take this, all of you, and eat of it, for this is my body which will be given up for you." In a similar way, when supper was ended, he took the chalice and, once more giving thanks, he gave it to his disciples, saying, "Take this, all of you, and drink from it. For this is the chalice of my blood, the blood of the new and eternal covenant, which will be poured out for you and for many for the forgiveness of sins. Do this in memory of me." The mystery of faith.
When we eat this bread and drink this cup, we proclaim your death, O Lord, until you come again.
Therefore, as we celebrate the memorial of his death and resurrection, we offer you, Lord, the bread of life and the chalice of salvation, giving thanks that you have held us worthy to be in your presence and minister to you. Humbly we pray that, partaking of the body and blood of Christ, you may be gathered into one by the Holy Spirit. Remember, Lord, your church spread throughout the world, and bring her to the fullness of charity, together with Francis our Pope, Gilbert our Bishop, and all the clergy. Remember also our brothers and sisters who have fallen asleep in the hope of the resurrection, and all who have died in your mercy. Welcome them into the light of your face. Have mercy on us all, we pray, that with the Blessed Virgin Mary, Mother of God, with Saint Joseph, her most chaste spouse, with the blessed apostles and all the saints who have pleased you throughout the ages, we may marry to be coerced to eternal life, and may praise and glorify you through your Son, Jesus Christ. Through him and with him and in him, O God, Almighty Father, in the unity of the Holy Spirit, all glory and honor is yours forever and ever.
Amen, amen, amen.
Jesus taught us to call God our Father, and so we have the courage to pray.
this day our daily bread, and forgive us our trespasses, as we forgive those who trespass against us. And lead us not into temptation, but deliver us from evil.
Deliver us, Lord, we pray, from every evil. Graciously grant peace in our days, that by the help of your mercy, we may be always free from sin and safe from all distress, as we await the blessed hope in the coming of our Savior, Jesus Christ.
For the kingdom, the power, and the glory are yours, now and forever.
Lord Jesus Christ, you said to our apostles, "Peace I leave you, my peace I give you. Look not on our sins, but on the faith of your church, and graciously grant her peace and unity in accordance with your will, who live and reigns forever and ever.
Amen.
The peace of the Lord be with you always.
And with your spirit.
Let us offer each other the sign of peace.
Lamb of God, who take away the sins of the world, have mercy on us. Lamb of God, who take away the sins of the world, have mercy on us. Lamb of God, who take away the sins of the world, grant us peace. Those who are unable to kneel, please remain standing with reverence.
Behold the Lamb of God, behold him who takes away the sins of the world. Blessed are those called to the supper of the Lamb.
Lord, I am not worthy that you should enter under my roof, but only say the word, and my soul shall be healed. Second collection, which will be done, is for the continuing development of the parish and national shrine of Saint Padre Pio, and for the needs and welfare of the sick and retired priests of the Archdiocese of Lipa. Thank you for your offerings.
Iwang sa langit mga anghel na banal, at sa lupa'y manalangin at magpuri sa Ama, ipinangakong kaligtasan ay narito na sa pagkabuhay ni Jesus ay ating nadama. Sa langit mga anghel na banal at sa lupa'y manalangin at magpuri sa Ama, ipinangakong kaligtasan ay narito na sa pagkabuhay ni Jesus ay ating nadama.
Please all stand.
Let us pray. Grant us, we pray, Almighty God, that the true divinity of your only begotten Son, which we firmly profess with Saint Athanasius, may through this sacrament ever give us life and protection through Christ our Lord.
Amen. Prayer for intercession to Saint Padre Pio. All together. Padre Pio, holy monk from Pietrelcina, outstanding saint of the present era, our bright beacon in this earthly pilgrimage, our sanctuary in times of trouble, holy exemplar of great courage. With you our needs do we confide, as well as our livelihood, our health, and our might. Unworthy as we are, we pray that we concede. Bless and grace us that our lives may be fulfilled. From sin may we abstain. In God may we remain. We also beseech thee, servant of the Most Holy, to instruct us in the gospel that we may reflect and believe. Our requests are before thee. Our hearts repent, resolving earnestly to not sin again, to always follow God the Father, together with the Spirit, and Jesus the Mediator. Amen. Please be seated for some announcement. Una, sa inyong pagdalaw sa pambansang Dambana, mangyaring pakaingatan ng inyong mga personal na gamit. Hangad namin ang isang matiwasay at maayos na pagbisita sa National Shrine. Ikalawa, sa pagnanais nating palawakin ang dokumentasyon at datos ng mga pilgrims and devotees na bumibisita sa pambansang Dambana, kami po ay nag-aanyaya sa inyong lahat na makilahok sa ginagawang pagkalap ng impormasyon na makakatulong sa pagpapaunlad ng turismong pangsimbahan. Makikisuyo po kami na pakiscan ang QR code na inyong makikita sa paligid ng simbahan at pakikumpleto ng mga impormasyong kinakailangan. Makakaasa po kayo sa aming pag-iingat ng private information na inyong ibabahagi bilang pagsunod sa batas ng Data Privacy Act of 2012. Ang inyong pakikisa ay malaking tulong at susi sa tagumpay ng proyektong ito. 4 ng Mayo ay unang Sabado ng buwan. Mayroon po tayong prosesyon sa karangalan ng Mahal na Birhen sa ganap na 5 ng umaga, nasisimula natin sa may harap ng Fountain of Hope. Ang mga sasama ay nangyayahang magdala ng kandila. Maraming salamat po at mangyaring panatilihin natin ang kalinisan, katahimikan, at diwa ng pananalangin sa loob at labas ng ating simbahan. Magsitayo na po ang lahat para sa pagbabasbas ng mga religious articles.
O Lord, you are the source of all blessings and grace. Pour out your blessing on these instruments of prayer, rosaries, images, prayers, roses, and other religious items that remind us of your goodness, holiness, and love to us, so that all who came and prayed through them may receive your mercy and grace. Through them, help the faithful imitate the holiness and teaching of the Lord and the saints forever.
Amen. Our Father in heaven, hallowed be your name. Your kingdom come, your will be done on earth as it is in heaven. Give us this day our daily bread, and forgive us our trespasses, as we forgive those who trespass against us. And lead us not into temptation, but deliver us from evil. Amen. Hail Mary, full of grace, the Lord is with you. Blessed are you among women, and blessed is the fruit of your womb, Jesus. Holy Mary, Mother of God, pray for us sinners, now and at the hour of our death. Amen. Hail Mary, full of grace, the Lord is with thee. Blessed are you amongst women, and blessed is the fruit of your womb, Jesus. Holy Mary, Mother of God, pray for us sinners, now and at the hour of our death. Amen. Glory be to the Father, and to the Son, and to the Holy Spirit, as it was in the beginning, is now, and will be forever. Amen. Glory be to the Father, and to the Son, and to the Holy Spirit, as it was in the beginning, is now, and will be forever. Amen.
The Lord be with you.
And with your spirit.
And may the Almighty God bless you, the Father, the Son, and the Holy Spirit.
Amen.
Go forth, the celebration is ended.
Thanks be to God.
Glory to God, proclaim his name, Jesus.